It's time to stand up. No matter what your race, creed, or sexual preference, a change has come. Either you get on board, step aside, or get left behind. I don't know about you, but I woke up this morning with a new sense of pride. I felt that I can do anything, anything that I put in my mind, yeah. I got a brand new walk, a brand new talk. There's something different about me. I think I know what it is. I see it in others as they're passing by me, yeah. When I walk down the street, everyone that I meet has a smile on their face.
A change has come.
When I turn on the news and I see the news crews and the pandemonium,
a change has come.
I see the tears in their eyes, I hear the cheers in their sighs.
Good evening. This is Clifton Graves, host of UGMA, a public affairs presentation produced by Citizens Television here in New Haven, Greater New Haven. And my guest tonight is Mr. Tom Ficklin of the Ficklin Media Group. This basically is a second part of our follow-up, rather, to our May show, which focused on the Obama Initiative, a mentoring program that being conducted and being wound down now by Tom Ficklin and myself in the New Haven public school system. We're going to talk a little bit about the response to the May show here on CTV, as well as the reaction, quite frankly, that we received around the country in response to the Obama Initiative being shown on Facebook and then on YouTube. That thanks to Mr. Ficklin's technological genius. Before we get into tonight's topic, though, part two of the Obama Initiative, I'd like to mention, as always, the events in the news that have transpired since our last production. First, of course, you heard at the opening a song from the legendary Temptations, believe it or not, with their latest CD, believe it. They have a new CD called Still Here. After 50-some years, Tom, the Temptations were indeed my favorite group of all time. They have a new CD called Still Here. That cut that you heard is called Change Has Come. It's basically a tribute to the election and of Barack Obama as President of the United States. And it talks about the change, certainly that President Obama talked about during his campaign. But more importantly, the Temptations, the lyrics of the song address the challenge that all of us still face, and the challenges we still face, and the struggles we still face as a people, as a country, as a world, as we attempt to try to reconcile the change symbolized by President Obama, but the challenges that each of us still must face up to and embrace when it comes to making positive change in the present and the future. So that Temptations cut number two on the Temptations new CD, Still Here, is something that we want to totally acknowledge. And also in that song, if you hear all the lyrics, they make reference to the Sam Cooke classic, A Change Is Going to Come. And of course, they reference that and certainly use that as a backdrop and a basis and a foundation for the change that is now here, but the changes we still have in store that we have to continue to work toward. And on that note, as always, we make note, if we can, of doing this show, of those who have passed on. And it's symbolic and significant that one of the legendary Temptations, Ali Woodson, one of the great lead singers, in fact, one of the greatest lead singers during the course of the Temptations' existence and the transitions and transformations they've gone through, passed on and since we last met, and want to acknowledge Ali Woodson's passing. Ali Woodson was most probably best known for his lead on Treat Her Like a Lady, that we'll hear a little bit from later on in the show. Also, he was a great writer and a great great contributor to the Temptations' legacy. And also, since we last met, want to acknowledge the passing of Marvin Isley, a part of the Isley Brothers family. He was part of the Isley, Jasper Isley group and 3+3 with the Isley Brothers, and he passed on as well. And finally, Manute Bol. We mentioned Manute Bol this past week during one of our Obama Initiative programs. Manute Bol, some of you may know, was a brother from the Sudan who played in the National Basketball Association. He was seven feet 6 inches tall. And certainly he was noted for that, of course, and his ability to play basketball. And certainly he played in the NBA for several years with both the Washington Wizards, the Philadelphia 76ers, as well as I think the Golden State Warriors, a few other teams. And because of his, and he certainly played the game because of his height and his ability to block shots. But his legacy, as was noted throughout this past week by sports commentators and newscasters mm-hmm. around the country, Manute Bol's contribution certainly surpassed his talents on the basketball court. In fact, he was a great humanitarian. Mm-hmm. Being coming from the Sudan that has been engrossed in a major civil war for years now, and certainly a struggle, their political and social struggle, Manute Bol used his notoriety, his fame as a basketball player, to raise funds and to actually build a hospital, hospitals there and there in the Sudan. And also, there was a time, Tom, that was noted by certain sportscasters during the past week. Manute Bol, you know, this NBA has certain time frames you have to report to camp and for training, what have you. He got fined once because while he was supposed to be here for training camp, he was in Sudan negotiating a peace, trying to broker a peace between the warring factions there in his native country. And of course, I think the team paid the fine. But the point is that while some basketball players here in this country certainly do give back, we have to know, and professionals and other professional athletes, football, baseball, et cetera, they give back to the communities that either they grew up in or that they're a part of. This man that was noted tried to give to his entire country. He tried to build hospitals mm-hmm. to save lives and to broker a peace deal to save the lives of his countrymen. So we acknowledge again Manute Bol, the life and legacy of Manute Bol. And for Connecticut folk, we should note Manute Bol, while he was from the Sudan, he actually played basketball at the University of Bridgeport. Yes. His college, yes. His alma mater was University of Bridgeport mm-hmm. before he went on to the NBA. And actually Connecticut, he actually lived here in Connecticut.
Yes.
And was seen here throughout, around the state from time to time, in the Hartford area, Bridgeport area, from time to time. So we acknowledge the passing of Manute Bol and his life and legacy as we segue into tonight's discussion.
You know what also,
Clint, go ahead, Tom.
You may get accused of, because I think if memory serves, Lena Horne.
Absolutely, we did.
Passed away since we were here last as well. So we could talk about her for another 2,000 years.
Oh, for sure.
Deservedly. But it's a proper time to lift up her name as well in this.
Well, actually, we did mention her in the last, I knew we covered it briefly, but because it came in the aftermath of Dorothy Hyde and Benjamin.
Yes,
we did mention Lena Horne, but I think but her legacy certainly bears mentioning again. In terms, because we again, were not for Lena Horne, there would be no Halle Berry, quite frankly, or Angela Bassett and many other great actresses who were also entertainers in different aspects. She opened the doors widely and made it very clear that she would speak out. She supported Dr. King and others, marched in the civil rights movement, was very active and spoke out against injustices in the entertainment industry and beyond. And certainly we want to acknowledge again the Lena Horne. So with that, tonight again, this is our June 22nd show. June 22nd, presentation of the Obama, of UGMA, and as we noted earlier, during the May production, we focused on the Obama Initiative program being conducted at both Lincoln Bassett and Wexler Grant schools, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade boys primarily, focusing on the challenges that they face trying to. We attempted through this program to use not as a political vehicle, certainly the name of President of Obama, but primarily the symbolism that the president's election and symbolizes, and certainly we use that name to motivate. While we could have used Malcolm X or Dr. King or Thurgood Marshall or Constance Baker Molly or many others, but certainly we could Adam Clayton Powell. I mean, there are any number. Frederick Douglass, any number of folks who come to mind that were worthy,
yes.
Certainly Paul Robeson, worthy of a program of motivation and inspiration. But because these young boys, we live in a day when certainly with YouTube and Facebook and media, so many media outlets that they see someone they could see that's live and well, that they could see and relate to in terms of accomplishment, and but also the challenge and the struggles and the criticism that the president faces on, yes. on a daily basis. We thought it was symbolic and significant to use the Obama, President Obama's name and contribution, and certainly his achievement as a means to lift up, inspire, and motivate these young boys. But in the aftermath of that, certainly we've gotten some positive comments, and we thank CTV again. We want to acknowledge the staff here at CTV, certainly Joe Schofield, the general manager here, and thanking him for giving us this opportunity to show this, to demonstrate this project. And certainly I certainly acknowledge and our appreciation to Dr. Reginald Mayo, Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Charles Warner, who's now retiring, but we certainly want to acknowledge his assistance in making this program possible, as well as the principals and staff. The staffs at Lincoln Bassett, the principal Ramona Gaddison, the Tom's going to read, and certainly with Kevin Muhammad, principal at Wexler Grant, as well as their respective staffs for making these programs possible at these schools. And with that, I'm going to have Tom Sayre have a few comments before we show some clips in shortly from our more recent Obama initiative program and the response that we've gotten. And we want to say this because, quite frankly, in the last few weeks, we've created this firestorm around the country, not just locally, but from positive responses we've gotten from the program and from the show last month, but on Facebook and on YouTube, Dr. Mayo, Superintendent of Schools, has received a number of phone calls and letters. There have been a number of responses that Tom, some not so positive, that Tom will read for you that we've gotten on YouTube. And certainly even Ramona Gaddison, Principal Ramona Gaddison and her staff received phone calls at Lincoln Bassett, negative phone calls as far away as from California and Texas, from people who saw the our excerpts of the Obama initiative at Lincoln Bassett and Wexler Grant in response to that. And even the State Board of Education, an attorney, I believe, even called. So it just shows you again that perhaps maybe sometimes when you do things, you don't realize the impact it might have, and sometimes it takes it shows you again maybe by the response we've gotten that maybe it's a good thing that we're doing, quite frankly. So Tom, please share some light on this.
Well, Cliff, absolutely, and it's a blessing in disguise, and it's a sobering reality, but also a challenge for us now to kind of be really cognizant of what we're engaged in.
Sure.
And you can have your thoughts about something, but then to see it manifested and then it gets put out into the universe and have the universe respond negatively and positively. We forget that this really is now one world because of new media. So before we show this clip, it's going to be kind of the excerpts of the graduation from Wexler Grant, and State Representative Gary Holder Winfield's going to speak, and yourself, and some comments from myself, but also we conclude with three comments from some of the students, and the chant is in the beginning and the chant is at the end. But I have in my hand 11 pages, and this is not all of it, of comments from various websites such as Newsbusters, and one says, a speaker leads students in a creepy chant of "I am an Obama scholar" at Lincoln Bassett as part of an educational program called the Obama Initiative. Another one mentions, "Mein Führer, I will follow you." We were accused of being Nazis and indoctrinating the young boys.
And brainwashing them.
And brainwashing. Yeah. And then another says, well, by the time they graduate, it might be a useful endeavor to chant Zig Heil. Another mentions, just another twisted nail in the damnable edifice of Obama as president for life. Another, while mad, behinds are an important issue in education and development in the Muslim world. They are not and should not be considered a threat to the United States. There's some typos there. By the way, you've been called an iman in some of this, not knowing your name. The brainwashing will continue. A great leap forward is referenced. We're going to go to the clip so people can see what actually takes place. And it's difficult to conduct this program without appearing biased. So we really wanted to still be full-fledged, open, and objective. And on my website at tomficklin.blogspot.com, and if you call the station, or they'll probably put my website up, you can see the various links, which we'll continue to post. This is just, this will continue, because this show will be on YouTube. The program hopes to continue in September. So we really see this to be just part of our initiative, our Obama Absolutely. Initiative, symbolically and substantively, and let the chips fall where they may. But it, at some point, you can talk the talk, or you can walk the walk, and we're involved with walking the walk. I would like to read a letter that Principal Ramona Garrison from Lincoln Bassett Gaddison, issued yes. to Gaddison rather, yes. Thank you, submitted to the parents. I mean, Absolutely. she was forced to do this, but again, it shows the proactivity that we do live in a glass house. The world is a glass house now because of the media.
Sure.
And so we're being spied on. You can spy on others. We're being observed. You can observe others. But it's the interaction is going on like crazy, and the ideological battles have never been higher. So. Mrs. Gaddison wrote to the parents and guardians on June 17th. I'm just going to read a part. It is with great pride that we the Lincoln Bassett School community, recognize an outstanding program that has been housed at Lincoln Bassett and Wexler Grant. Again, if you're a parent of a student at Lincoln Bassett or Wexler Grant, and you hear about this or see something on Fox News, you want to know what's going on with your students. True. So she's been proactive and endorsing what we're involved with and putting her reputation on the line, which again, we very, very much appreciate. Exactly. The Obama Initiative for Males, it is a program that provides young males in grades 6 through 8 the opportunity for networking with positive male role models. The goal of this program is to enhance education and instill strong character traits. And she goes on to talk about the Worthwhile program. There's also the possibility of the register who came yes. to one of the sessions at Lincoln Bassett yes. to kind of illustrate our openness. And that article, we hope, still might appear. At least they were there and they took pictures. So there's a possibility of the register article appearing, and the students made comments then. And the feedback during that session, the feedback from our students, Mrs. Gaddison, Principal Gaddison continues, the feedback from our students that has been very positive and exposed them to various careers and opportunities that are available. Unfortunately, she goes on to say, there are some who do not feel that our students should be knowledgeable and aspire to achieve the necessary requirements to be a person to pursue a career in medicine, architecture, journalism, et cetera. So this was just one example where communities will sometimes rally when there's pressure put upon them, and this sure. is just one example of that happening. But let's go to the clip, and again, it's just those five letters, as you mentioned, O-B-A-M-A, and so it might be the Cliff Initiative, and if it was a Tom Initiative, we wouldn't have sure. attracted attention. But it's really fascinating, right. But we want our audience to actually see what takes place, and we're really excited about being engaged in this historical struggle.
And before we show the clip, just quickly, I wanted to just acknowledge, if we can, if the camera will show, the T-shirts and the certificates that we have here, the young boys who have participated in the program, as well as the principals, will receive a certificate of attendance and participation, as well as the T-shirt that we have here and on display that has been handed out and will be handed out at both Lincoln Bassett and Wexler Grant schools to the participants as well. So we just want to make sure we know that as well. All right. So with that, I guess we can show the clip that Tom referred to.
It's about 20 minutes. So don't go away. Stay there.
Stay with us.
Because it's really instructive, and we want to comment on it and look forward to your comments as well.
Yeah, Gary Holder Winfield, state representative, was the speaker at the Wexler Grant last Friday, the 18th. Final presentation. So we can show that now.
I thank you, Mr. Ficklin. I thank you for being here, for your attention. We hope we're able to share something with you. Plant a seed, as Mr. Muhammad just said. Plant a seed. It may not flower tomorrow or next week, but down the road, maybe look back on this experience of being together like this. People you brought before you, like the man you're going to see and hear from in a minute. State Representative Gary Holder Winfield, the folks from the Firebirds, the other professional black men who came before you, others who've done and achieved great things, others who had bumps in the road, who served time in jail, who came to share those experiences with you, but all in out of love for you, as Mr. Muhammad indicated, love and concern for you, your present, and your future. We hope you take that to heart. You know, this is no game we're playing, it's serious business outside those walls. You should also know this, and I think I can say this okay, Mr. Fickle, that you should know that the fact that we're here is because we care about you and love you. But y'all, you should know this, there are people outside these walls who got problems with this program. They don't like the fact that we coming in here talking to you. the people who look like me and Mr. Ficklin and Mr. Coach Winfield and Mr. Jones and some of your principal are doing a program like this. They don't like it. And not only that, they're saying stuff about us all around the country. They got a dabbles on YouTube saying that, showing excerpts from this class, and a Lincoln Bassett saying terrible things about us. That we're trying to propagandize you about President Obama, and that we're doing the wrong thing. And this is not good. So understand that even good things we try to do, we told those mountains we have to overcome, which we're going to deal with in a minute, that mountains of hate and ignorance that are still out there, that we have to deal with every single day. Mr. Hummer has to deal with, Mr. Fickler, Mr. Joyner, certainly Mr. Holden Winfield as a state rep, and myself. And we're trying to prepare you brothers and that. This is serious business. And we're trying to do something positive for you, and there are people outside who don't look like us, who think this is a bad thing. They think this is terrible. They're saying terrible things about me, about Mr. Fickler, about Mr. Muhammad, about Dr. Mayo, about even doing a program like this. See how crazy this world is? How crazy this world is. And that's what we're up against. So we're trying to prepare you for that crazy world. Outside these walls and these streets, and also the outside this community, where people don't like even things like this, positive things we try to do to help ourselves. Which goes back to Mr. Muhammad's point, we need you. Prepare yourselves, start preparing yourselves right now. Not tomorrow, not yesterday, not next week, not when you get to Hill House and Career Cross, but right now, prepare yourself to be leaders in the community, to protect yourself, defend yourselves against these attacks that are going to come. The internal attacks from folks who look like us, then the external attacks from folks who do. You need to make ends meet. Because I want to hear, we're going to do a couple things today. This is our last session. We're going to hear from State Representative Gary Holden Winfield, who's been great to sacrifice his time. Let's give him another hand. Third or fourth time coming here, coming to visit. And again, this is someone who represents you. As he explained to you before, he's voted, elected to serve us in Hartford, represent us in Hartford, and he cares so much about you. He's here again.
Right.
And then again, understand this. You guys, now, something you think about politicians, some politicians, well, they only come to people who can vote for them, who open up to vote. They're short places for people over 18, because other folks can vote. None of you guys, nobody here 18, right? I mean, none of you students 18. Right?
I hope
that here we heard that. So the point is, he's here because he cares about you. He loves you and concerned about you and your well-being. So that's why we appreciate his presence once again, to come and just not to do a drive-by or a walk-by in this one time, one or two times. He's been here, this is the fourth time coming, to show his concern and commitment to you. But we're going to hear from him in a minute. Before we start, though, let's begin today as we've done these last few weeks. Everybody stand up.
All right.
Stand up, those brothers, straight.
Solar plexus.
Yeah, there we go. Everybody stand up. Yeah, there we go. All right, I know you were watching the game last night. Get up anyway. That's all right. Yeah, I know.
Speaking of the game, when it came time to man up, Kobe manned up. So somebody got to show leadership. When everybody's sinking and sliding, shucking and jiving, somebody got to have their own mind and say, you know what? Nobody else would take charge. I'm going to take charge of me. So while we say this little chant with Mr. Gray, you think about your future and mean what you say and say what you mean. This helps me out. Sometimes I get down. Sometimes I need somebody to help me. So this little quote that he's going to give you, little chant, helps me out as well.
All right. Thank you, brother. Anybody want to help us? Who's helping today? Anybody? Come on down, brother. Yeah. Come on down. Yeah. All right. Come on, Trey. That's good. Right, Trey? All right.
Sure.
Vision of who? Yes, we can. Yes, we can. All right. Everybody ready? We're going to go with you. Everybody, mountain!
Mountain!
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Mountain!
Mountain!
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Mountain the guns.
Mountain the guns.
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Mountain the drugs.
Mountain the drugs.
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Mountain the violence.
Mountain the violence.
Mountain the violence.
Mountain the violence.
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Mountain the ignorance.
Mountain the ignorance.
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Cause I am. Somebody.
Somebody.
And I can be.
And I can be.
And I will be.
And I will be.
Anything.
Anything.
I want to be.
I want to be
doctor,
lawyer,
judge, journalist,
educator,
engineer,
entrepreneur,
principal,
president,
anything, I want to be.
I want to be.
If my mind,
if my mind,
can't conceive it,
can't conceive it,
in my heart,
Tony.
Can believe it.
Can believe it.
And I know.
And I know.
I know.
I know.
I know.
I know.
I can achieve.
I can achieve.
Mountain.
Mountain.
Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
If I am.
I am.
I'm an Obama scholar.
I'm an Obama scholar.
I'm an Obama scholar.
An Obama scholar.
I strive to be.
I strive to be.
Outstanding.
Outstanding.
Brilliant.
Brilliant.
I will achieve.
I will achieve.
I'll be motivated.
I'll be motivated.
elevate.
With a positive attitude.
Positive attitude.
Positive attitude.
Positive attitude.
Mountain.
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 Move out of my way.
Move out of my way.
Give yourselves a hand. We're gonna do right now. I want to hear. We'll do two couple things today. We want to hear from first from State Representative Gary Holder Winfield. Well, I already introduced and complimented for the great work he's doing for all of us in Hartford. He wants to say some closing remarks to you brothers as we go forward. Because life doesn't stop. I mean, the program stops, but life goes on.
Right.
And the issues and challenges that we talked about these last few weeks will still be out there on the streets confronting you every single day. So he's gonna talk a little bit about that. Then we want to hear from you. I want you to talk to us. I want to join us, say a few words. Of course, Brother Muhammad, Mr. Fickle will weigh in. We want to hear from you guys and your comments, your reactions to what we've done these last few weeks. Is that all right? So I'm going to give you a few minutes to think about what you might want to say, because Mr. Fickle has it on tape here. We want to talk about it and have you talk to us about, you know, what you got out of this program and what we can do to improve things in the future. Bless you, young brother. Bless you.
Thank you.
But with that, this is your brother, your State Representative Gary Holder Winfield.
Good morning again.
Good morning.
You know, Chan talks about all the things you can be, right? That's what this Chan talks about. And from where you're sitting, sometimes it's a little difficult to understand that you can be all of those things that you talk about. Let me tell you something. I come from a community in the South Bronx where people think that you can't be anything. I come from a house that was broken. My mother's a single mother who worked, and she worked round the clock. I got a father who's a drug addict. Covered, but he never came back to his family. So I have a lot of the issues that some of you may have and that some people still may have, and I come from a place where people don't think you can achieve. And let me tell you, in the chant you talk about being an engineer and an entrepreneur and the president, well, I've been an engineer and I've been an entrepreneur and I'm a state representative and maybe someday I'll be the president. And what that says is, Mr. Gray said, you know, when you look at us, you see yourselves. When I look at you, I see myself. Because not too long ago, I sat in a similar situation to where you are. And I've done all of those things. Hey, you, up here. This is real talk. Let me tell you something. I'll tell you the truth about something, right? I asked you guys when I came here before how tough you were. Remember that? Some of you remember that? I asked you how tough you were. You remember that, right? And the reason I asked you that is because there are a lot of things you got to deal with out there when you go outside these doors, right? How tough are you? Can you make it to where I'm standing? Because I know that if you do what's necessary, you can be here, because I did. But the question is, are you tough enough to get there? And today, when you turn around, and you're not paying attention, you're demonstrating something. You're demonstrating that you're not tough enough to function in this room. And it's tougher to function out on the street. Now, I know every single one of you is tough enough to go out to the corner and get what you got to get to do what you got to do on the street, because that's easy. That's the easy thing to do. So you're tough enough to do that. My question again to you is, are you tough enough to be standing here, to go through the trials that are necessary, to be here, to talk to some young people and save their lives? How many people in this room are tough enough to do that? Raise your hands. Come on. How many? Your hands should jump up in the air.
Right.
You should believe it. You just chanted, "Mountain, get out of my way." And you can't put your hands in the air. Something's wrong with it. You got to believe that. You got to believe it. It's not just something you say. It's not just something that sounds nice. You have to believe that you have the ability to do anything. This week when I was at Lincoln Bassett, I talked to them about why you can do it. And I'm going to tell you why you can do it the same way I told them. And I'm going to tell you why you can do it. Because you are different than those who came before you. And that difference is important. You're going to go to school. You're going to interact with all these people. You're going to learn a whole bunch of skills that you don't even know you have. Skills to prepare you to deal with the world. But there's something else that's different about you than even people of my generation, and certainly people before. When they listen to music, how do they listen to music? They listen to music, the song will come on, the song is all right. They listen to it, the song's not all right. They don't listen to it, and then the song goes away, right? Do we listen to music like that?
No.
No, what do? We listen to a song, the song's hot. Everybody, we have a different kind of swagger, right? We want to be the hottest on everything, right? That's how we are. We want to be the hottest. So if they got a hot track out, somebody jumps on that track, and what do they say? They say, "I'm going to spit something that's more fire than what the original got spit," right? That's what they do. Or if the track's not that hot, they put a new track under. Hey, you, hey, up here.
Come on, Dave.
Real talk. Me and you, come on. So they put a new track under, and then they come out, and sometimes that track is better than the original track. So we remix things, right? That's part of how you've grown up, right? Everybody here has heard a remix, right? Has anybody not heard a remix? All right, so if you turn on the radio, in the last few months you've heard Beamer Benz Avenue, right? Anybody not know this song? Right? Everybody knows this song. What's that song about? It's about cars, it's about all the flashy stuff, right? But women, but have you heard the remixes? Have you heard the remixes, right? Now, let me ask you a question. Joel Ortiz is on the remix, right? What's Joel Ortiz talking about?
Joel Santana, right?
No, he's on the radio.
Okay, Joel.
I know this song real well. Okay, right. Joel Ortiz, what's he talking about? He's talking about Nissan Honda Chevy, right? That's what this brother's talking about. He comes out and he's like, in my hoopty I be swerving, people who I'm serving, boost phone, verbal chirping, Nissan Honda Chevy. This is what he's talking about. Now, this is a song that's about Beamer, Benz, Bentley. This is a song that's about hot women. This is a song that's about a fly chain. This is a song that's about all these excesses. And when Joel comes on, do you stop bobbing your head? Nah. Actually, Joel is probably one of the hotter verses on this track, right? Because Nissan Honda Chevy itself becomes a song. So what did Joel do? He flipped it. He made it different. And you are still bobbing your head to something that's going left when the rest of the song is going right. So now why am I talking to you about this? Because right now, you're sitting here and you're all going right. Nobody's going left. Right now, nobody's remixing what's going on in their life. Nobody's saying, you know what, this ain't hot. The people who came before me, they did the same thing that I'm doing. The same exact thing. And I know where they ended up. They ended up running the streets for a little while. Yeah, they were doing all right. But there's nobody that's 50 years old out there running those streets. There's nobody that's 45 years old out there running the streets. There's very few people out there that are 35 running those streets. And I don't want to be doing the same thing. I don't want to be doing the same track. Because the same track is whack. And I'm hotter than that. I'm a better MC. I'm a better DJ. I'm a better whatever I am. I'm a better student.
Step out.
I'm a better possible leader.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to do it different.
Step out.
So I ask you again, because I know you have something that I didn't necessarily have, that I know Mr. Graves didn't have because he's a little bit older. I know that you are adaptable to situations. I ask you, how many of you in this room, and I want you to throw your hands up, how many of you in this room are adaptable enough, understand the remix enough? How many of you in this room are tough enough to stand where I'm standing as a DJ? How many? Put your hands up. Now that's better. You can do anything. And the reason you can do anything is because you have the ability to adjust the situations. I didn't get here just because I was a good student in school. I didn't get here just because everything was right in my life. I got here because, like you, I understand that you have to adapt to situations. I got here because I was tough. I got here with people threatening my lives when I was defending people like you. I got here because I am who you are, and I can, and you can be who I am. I got here because I was tough enough. And I got here because a few people love me. You got people in this room who say they love you, who come back. Take advantage of that. I'm going to give them my cell phone number. And I'm going to tell them to give that number to you. And when you need something, whether it be you be in trouble, you need some guidance, you need anything, you call that number. Because that's the number that's on my head. And I love you guys. And I know you're tough enough. And I want to help you get where you can be. So thank you.
I'd like to have State Representative Holder Whitfield let us know where he lives.
So I live in New Hallville. And I live right at the corner of Winchester and Division.
Real talk.
And the reason I live there, just real quick, the reason I live there is because a lot of people come to our communities talking about what should be happening, but they don't live in our communities. They don't see what goes on in our communities. And I don't think it's real to talk about what should happen without being there. And that's another thing. 480 Winchester Avenue, the yellow house on the corner of Winchester and Division. If you live close to there, even if you don't, if you can get there and you have an issue, you have a question, knock on the door, because that's where I am. Because I'm there for you. So thank you.
This man is, he doesn't know what he has done for me in my life. All the times that, you know, I've been in this community, we've had to get stories out. I was read his information in the inner city. This is in my early 20s, coming up in this community. I have a lot of respect for this man. He doesn't speak a lot, but
he was always hoped that we had somebody that would write positive articles about us and we're not always on the front cover going to jail or raping people or drug charge. This man, he's an unsung to me here in our community.
That's right.
Thank you,
Michael.
What I want to say is it's always been a dream of mine to have a team, a media team. So this experience has helped me to bring my dream to life. So the videos and the photos that you'll see, and we're going to make a copy for everybody, all of you that have helped me do this thus far, you're now on my team. And then we're going to continue in September. So I appreciate what Brother Muhammad said. And all of us, once you start on a path, you just continue on the path. But I wanted to thank you also for those of you that have taken pictures, helping with the video, because that's been a relief. And some of the pictures you've taken, because you looked at it, as Gary was talking about, through your eyes, you guys see things that have taken place in these sessions that I don't see, because you have a younger eye, you're refixing it as you focus on things. So just wanted to thank you, and we'll be back in September.
I just wanted to say that I appreciate you guys coming in. You helped me a lot, and you made me turn around from me being bad and stuff. Thank you.
Thank you. Listen, that's deep coming from him for me. That's deep.
I just want to thank all y'all for coming in today and all the times that they did come in to teach us about Obama and what's going on in our community. You really helped me a lot.
Thank you. Thank you. Going up. Yes, sir. Vision of hope. All right.
I just want to be careful because a lot of people in this community, in these neighborhoods, they don't even give us a chance to talk about being quiet, too busy doing something else.
Dontrell, I'm going to impose upon you. I need you to say it a little louder, like if you're on the ball field or something. Because for the video, and when you're on TV, you're going to have to project into the mic. So look this way and just speak a little louder.
I want to be grateful for having time to come in to talk to us. Nobody gets time to talk to us and teach us to be leaders.
All right. Thank you.
Helping us out because I know that kids like our age see a lot of shootings, a lot of drug dealings because they get a lot of girls in cars and stuff and want to be like them. Well, this is who we need to be like, and I thank them for sharing their time coming to us to talk to us.
Thanks for calling us young men. We appreciate that. We really appreciate that.
We're going to get ready to transition to the Wiz, but I'm going to let Mr. Christopher close out with our chant, and then we'll. Yeah. Follow me, Mr. Joyner, to the Wiz.
All right. Yeah. You want to stand up. Thank you. Thank you again.
I mean,
the Zoom out.
I want you to
participate
in the
chat. Hope you remember the words of Brother Muhammad, words of State Representative Brother Holder Winfield, Brother Joyner, Brother Fickman.
If you need any
assistance. Do it like this. Do it like this. Whatever's comfortable for you. All right. Don't break the circle now. Mountain, move out of my way. I will be anything I want to be.
Doctor.
Lawyer.
Engineer.
Educator.
Entrepreneur.
Principal.
President.
President.
Anything.
I want to be. With my mind. Can't conceive it. In my heart. Can't believe it. And I know. I can achieve it. Mountain.
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 Move out of my way.
Give yourselves a hand right now.
Straight lines. So,